GreenFe. I haven't heard that name in years. Howdy, partner. GreenFe. I can't keep that up. Hey guys, GreenFe, and in this 100 days video, I go back in time to the Minecraft Wild West. There are wild dogs that can hunt me down, gigantic bears that can maul me and kill me, and a massive custom-generated world to explore. Now, I know it doesn't actually look like this, but this is actually Minecraft hardcore, so if I make one small slip-up or mistake, I die for good. One last thing before the video starts, I just wanted to quickly thank everyone who subscribed last video. It actually really does help the channel grow, so thank you so much, I really appreciate it. Anyways, in this video, I spend 100 days in the Minecraft Wild West. Alright, day one. The first thing I did was look around and survey my surroundings. I realized I spawned right in front of a forest, so I chopped some wood and got some basic tools. I got a bit more wood and then headed off on my adventure. I was attacked by this wild dog, but I managed to bridge up and take him out from there. I kept walking around, trying to figure out a good place for a house. I tried to get a few seeds from the grass, and also some meat from the animals. Turns out, the frogs were actually poisonous. I upgraded my tools with some stone nearby, and then started clearing out an area for my house. Don't feel sorry for this little guy, because those rats are nasty, and they bite you. Turns out, you can only drink water from certain streams in this game.
I can't drink from this stream. That's weird.
This would become quite an issue later on. I ended up coming across a larger river, and you could drink from that, so thankfully I didn't die. I finished clearing out the land where my house would go, and then started construction. By this time it was getting pretty late, so I did the old stay in a box for the night trick. In the morning, I took the box down and gathered wood for the majority of the day. Later, I got up a little bit of a structure with the wood I gathered. I really wanted the house to look nice this time, and fit in with the surroundings. Also, turns out eating frog meat gives you jump boosts. Makes sense, I guess. In the evening, I gathered some sand from a nearby river. I wanted to use glass windows for my base, because I thought that looked the best. The next morning, I ended up killing some zombies. They definitely weren't as hard as the zombies from the nuclear winter video, but they were still annoying with basic tools. Later that day, I was out chopping trees, and then this happened.
Oh, whoa.
That night, I ate like a king.
Day 5.
Day 5, I decided it was a good day to start mining. I really wanted to make a water bucket, so I wouldn't have to go all the way to the large lake every time I wanted water. I ended up making it all the way to bedrock, but I still couldn't find any iron. Later that day, I added a floor to my house. To be honest, it wasn't practical, but it looked cool. I also just stood there. I guess I was admiring the floor. The next day, I went out exploring a little more. I didn't want to stray too far away, but each day I would get farther and farther away from my house. At this point, I needed iron more than I was letting on. I ended up finding a cave dog, so I guess that's a thing now.
Are you literally kidding me? Gold. So much gold. So many emeralds. Emeralds all around. But not a single iron ore. What is this? You know what? I think we're gonna go over there. Okay.
The lake seemed to be infested with piranhas, but I took them out and started exploring. Honestly, I wasn't looking for much. I just wanted to see what was going on. I didn't know why I wasn't finding iron, so I started a mine in the desert to see if the biome was the issue. I mined down to bedrock for the entirety of day 9, but I still found no iron.
Okay, well, I guess this biome definitely does not have iron.
The next day, I figured it was better to just forget about iron and focus on other things.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I pretty much went out gathering materials that day. I ended up exploring a pretty far ways away from my house and found a cave.
Are you kidding? Literal diamonds, but I don't have iron yet. What the heck? More diamonds. Those are diamonds right there. And those are diamonds right there. But I don't have iron yet. Oh my gosh, dude.
To tell you the truth, it was getting pretty hard to survive without iron. I didn't have a bucket or a shield or a decent sword, so things were pretty rough. That night, I decided I would mine for as long as it took to find iron.
Dude, does this have silk? Wait, what the heck? Okay, what the heck, man? So this was iron ore the whole time.
Turns out the entire time I was mistaking iron for coal. There was so much iron, I mined it all and brought it back up to the base. I also made a drinking trough, because for some reason the water I placed down I was able to drink. With this in my house, I wouldn't have to go all the way back to the big lake every time I wanted water. The next morning, I set out to find the diamonds in the cave I had found earlier.
Oh, yes! Nice. Oh, that feels so good. 2 diamonds, baby!
I also got a bit more coal, because I was running low on that. Afterwards, I went straight back to the house and crafted a diamond sword.
Look at this. Ooh, beauty.
After that, I remembered the underground cave I'd found earlier and got some emeralds and gold.
Look at how much gold there is. This is just a theory, but it looks like the diamonds spawn right beside the coal. Because there's lots of coal here, and there was diamonds beside it. And I guess that's how it happens, like how diamonds are made in real life, so I see why that would be logical. We're gonna chop this tree down. Yeah, I think we're gonna do that.
I guess for some reason I just didn't want that tree there anymore. I also chopped down a second spruce tree. I also went and chopped a ton more oak trees, but don't worry, I was gonna use them for something. I started crafting some stairs and planks and started building my roof. I figured my house would look a lot better with these changes, especially the spruce wood. While adding some windows, I was rudely interrupted.
Oh my gosh, I have had enough of this. Okay, creeper. Of this growling. What the heck, man? Not today.
I ended up finishing the roof before the nighttime came.
Honestly, think that looks pretty good. We don't have very much food left.
On day 15, I went out hunting for some animals.
Okay. Sorry. I feel bad when I kill them.
I figured this would be enough food to tide me over until my farm started kicking off. Later that day, I ended up detailing my house and sorting my chests. By the time I was done, things were looking a lot better. I ended up still needing a bit more wood, so I chopped down another spruce tree. Later that day, I added some bridges and cleared some land. I ended up clearing a lot of space. I needed room for a path I was planning. Later that night, I started outlining a small wheat farm. If you haven't noticed already, these next few days were about improving the base. I hadn't really explored very far up until that day, so the next day when I went out for some wood, I explored a bit farther. In this video, I really tried to make my builds fit in with the Western theme. They were aesthetic, yet practical.
So right now I can make a saddle with 3 leather, 2 iron, and 1 wool, or 5 leather and 3 iron. So either I get 1 wool or I get 1 more leather. But yeah, let's do that.
I almost killed this goat, but then I realized he was the key to getting my saddle.
Oh, yes! Oh my gosh, he follows me. Yes, he follows me.
I ended up having to use a boat to bring him home. I took him up the stream by my house and left him in the pond for the night. Then, I finally crafted the saddle.
Yes! Yes! Saddle. Okay, sweet. Nice.
Now, the previous day, I'd left the goat out in the pond, so on day 21, I built him an actual proper fence area. After that, I wanted to use my saddle, so I went out and got a horse.
There you go.
That night, my horse slept inside my house. Since my horse was living in my house, I decided to make a stable. I spent a lot of time gathering wood, but on day 23, I started construction. I ended up getting a bit sidetracked, so the next day is when the building really came together. I wanted the stable to stay true to the theme of the house, but I wanted it to be a bit different. I basically had to destroy half of my house to get my horse out, but in the end it was worth it. The next day, I added a path from my house to the stable. After that, I needed more sources of renewable food, so I started a melon farm. I also got rid of a ton of podzol, because that was getting really annoying. By this time, I was itching for adventure. At first, I didn't really find anything, because the desert was massive. But once I set out for the second time, I found an abandoned mineshaft. I also found a spider spawner, and inside one of the chests there were more saddles, and that was really good because I could get more horses. While I was doing this, I started gathering more resources for an enchanting table. Later that day, I wanted to test my theory about diamonds spawning near coal. I think it's pretty safe to say my theory was correct. I needed one more thing for the enchanting table, and that was a book. I gathered sugarcane and started a farm. I was also rudely attacked by some piranhas. Once I got home, I crafted the enchanting table. During the next few days, I found myself exploring a lot more. I also found myself taking more risks, which wasn't a good thing. The next day, I got iron and made an anvil. I also got some better tools as well. That night, I sat on my porch and relaxed. Who knew Minecraft could be so pretty? The next day, I went out to get some chickens. I brought them home and made a little coop for them. I figured I'd be able to breed them and make more chickens. I found out later you couldn't. Throughout the next few days, I started to get more animals. I discovered some goats and sheep on a mountain, and knew I wanted to bring them home. I wanted to have as many food sources as possible, so if one of them didn't work, I'd still have the others. The sheep were pretty annoying to transport, because they kept ignoring my wheat. I tried the boat strategy again, but the nighttime came and I almost actually died. The next day, I rode the sheep back to the house. I needed to create some sort of way to get the sheep from the boats into the pen. I ended up creating an airlock style entrance. You would go down into the tunnel, and then get the sheep into the pen. The next morning, I went out to get another sheep. The airlock style system seemed to be working pretty well. Later that day, I crafted an antique atlas. This would allow me to know where I was in the world at all times. On day 37, I spent the entire day mining. I didn't find a diamond, but I was determined. I also tried exploring that faraway coal cave, because I knew it had lots of coal. I was pretty sure there would be some diamonds where the coal spawned. After that, I decorated the base with these cool sand slabs. Day 39 was a good day. I went out exploring, and I found a dog. I gathered some resources and built him a doghouse. I wanted it to be as good as possible, with the highest quality material. In the end, I thought it looked pretty good. My dog didn't really want to go in though. So after that, I made a small bed in my house for him. Day 40 was also a good day. The next day, I set out to get some clay. Now, I needed the clay to make a coke oven and eventually make a water wheel. I used the clay to craft some coke bricks and built the oven.
There we go. Okay, let's see if this works.
I couldn't figure it out at the time, but the coal would produce coke coal and produce creosote oil as a byproduct.
Okay, it looks like we've got a little bit of creosote oil forming from this. So, yeah, I'll probably just leave this to do its thing and then we can go, like, mine some trees or something.
Now, the reason I needed creosote oil was because I needed that to make treated planks, and treated planks were a very crucial ingredient to make a water wheel.
Ooh, there we go.
I pretty much spent the entirety of day 44 getting coal. I wanted to make the water wheel as fast as possible, so I needed more treated wood. On day 45, I crafted most of the parts of the water wheel. I needed one more thing, steel. Unfortunately, to make steel, I needed a blast furnace. And unfortunately, to make a blast furnace, I needed to go to the Nether. I didn't want to do this, because I thought it broke the Western theme. But the next day, I created a Nether portal.
Okay, let's do this.
Last video, you guys told me to take more risks, so here I am, speed bridging over lava. To be honest, the Nether wasn't too bad. I did run into a little issue with the blazes and made a hidey hole under the spawner. Other than that, I got out pretty unharmed.
Nice.
On day 48, I finally made the blast furnace and got to work smelting some steel.
Okay, we'll wait for that to smelt and then we'll come back.
I also mined a ton of wood because I was going to need it for the water wheel structure. The steel was taking a long time, so I just worked on the structure and chopped some trees. Finally, at the end of the day, the steel was finished.
Oh, yes. Okay, and boom, 9 steel. Oh, that's awesome.
On day 50, I finally made the water wheel.
Oh, yes. Now I need to figure out a way to get the electricity from that wheel across and maybe power some lights and stuff. But first I'm gonna finish the structure because it is looking pretty barren.
And then I chop more trees. I wanted the water mill to look nice because I was gonna see it for the rest of the video. The water wheel would generate electricity for some lights I wanted. I actually put a lot of effort into the water mill, and in the end I thought it looked pretty good.
Nice. That does not look too shabby.
For the rest of the day, I harvested crops. The next day, I wanted to start drawing power from the water wheel. Although the wheel itself was set up, I actually wasn't getting any electricity. That day, I crafted a capacitor and a kinetic dynamo. When I attached the kinetic dynamo to the water wheel, it would generate electricity.
Look at that.
After that, I wired up the electrics.
There we go.
The next day, I was looking at some electric light recipes and found out you needed blueprints. Turns out you needed lapis to make blueprints. So with that, I went back down to the mines and found no lapis. I was spending a lot of time trying to find lapis. Turns out lapis doesn't spawn in this world, so I was wasting a lot of time for nothing. The next day, I prepared to go to the Nether again. Since I couldn't make electric lights, I was gonna make some glowstone alternatives. These glowstone lanterns are fine, I guess. I just want electric ones. I set them up around the base so mobs wouldn't spawn. I thought the base turned out quite nicely.
Oh, that looks so good. Oh, I love that.
I was still pretty bummed out with the whole light thing, so I took a break from the engineering. I wanted to make a barn, so I collected a lot of wood. Like always, construction was slow at first, but by day 59, I'd gotten most of the structure up. Once I filled in the walls, the barn looked a whole lot better. About halfway through, I realized I needed more wood for the roof. I spent a pretty long time on the roof because I wanted to get it right. After a few revisions, I thought it looked decent. The barn was really coming together, but I kept running out of wood. I ended up taking down a massive spruce tree, and that took me a few days. By day 64, I finished mining out the roots. After that, I got right to finishing the rest of the barn. I was also getting pretty decent at MLG water bucketing. The barn was pretty dark, so I collected a ton of coal and made some torches. After that, I brought some of my horses and put them in the barn. That reminds me, you guys voted on a name for my horse.
God, that's such a weird name. I can't believe you guys would choose that. Okay, I guess that's your name now.
That name is so strange. What kind of name is that? Anyways, I planted a wheat farm for the rest of the day. The next day, I looked up some gun crafting recipes that I would never use. They looked like they required a ton of iron, so it was back to the mines, baby. I decided diamonds were probably more of a priority, considering my pickaxe was almost broken. After exploring for a while, I found a spawner with a name tag and a music disc.
Cat! Yes! Yes! I made it!
Hey, what do you know? Day 69. I probably shouldn't celebrate too much, because my mom and my family watch my videos. Hi, mom. I ended up getting really lucky that day. I found some emeralds and some iron. The next day, I found a massive coal deposit with 6 diamonds. On day 71, I got up and wanted to do something monumental.
I want to make a bridge from here to there that goes across.
I started chopping trees because this project was going to take a ton of wood. After that, I started construction.
This is going to go like straight past us, so we have to rebuild this.
After that minor hiccup, I got right back to work. Later that day, I found a skeleton with a power 1 bow, so that was a nice upgrade. I wanted the bridge to have rails, so I got some from the mineshaft.
Wait, there's... No way, dude! What the heck? Spawner there. And then a spawner there. That is weird.
The next day, I put the mineshaft tracks onto the bridge. I also counted and measured the bridge, so I could add some support beams. I kept having to go and chop more wood, because the bridge needed a ton. I was literally spending entire days chopping wood, but in the end, I had enough. Sort of. I thought adding some side platforms would make the bridge look nicer. I also added some fences in between the support beams. The next day, I tested the rails, and they were slow, so I added some powered rails. It was a lot faster after that. On day 83, I made a small house on the closest side of the bridge. I mainly made this as sort of a checkpoint where I could rest. I also started carving a path, because climbing the mountain was really getting annoying. After that, I planned and built the pathway back to my house. The next few days, I started chopping down a ton of trees. I needed the wood because I was going to build something massive on the mountain. At one point, I must have gotten a little bored chopping trees, so I pretended I was a robot. Just look at that machine precision. Anyways, on day 90, I went across and started preparing for what I was gonna build. I had to clear out a ton of trees and bushes and land, but in the end, it was totally worth it. On day 92, I started planning out the structure for a mansion on the mountain. And on day 93, I got most of the walls up and started the roof. Now, you might be wondering, if I already have a house, why am I making another one? Anyways, I finished the roof and detailed the house. The next few days, I brought some items over from my old house and brought them to my new house.
Come on. Good boy. What do you think? I think he likes it. Come on, Harpoon, let's go.
The last few things I did was make a dog bed, upgrade my armor, and make a fancy floor. Finally, I woke up on day 100.
Yes! Yes! Oh, that feels so good. Yes!
I did it. I survived 100 days in the Minecraft Wild West. Now, wait, before you click off, I have a few important announcements. Firstly, I do actually have a Discord server, so if you want to hang out with a ton of really cool people that enjoy similar content, feel free to join that in the description. Now, not many people know about the next thing, but I do actually have an Instagram, Twitter, and Patreon, so if you want to follow me to see cool posts and potentially get a sneak peek into my next videos, consider following me at GreenFe_YT or joining my Patreon. Finally, the custom mod pack I use for this video is linked in the pinned comment in the comment section for free, so if you want to play on a similar world as this one, you can go check that out. Anyways, that's it from me. Peace!